Morning guys, in the continuation of the previous lecture, now we are going to learn about to find the expression for EMF induced in the transformer. You know the symbol of transformer, primary winding you have, secondary winding, let V1 be the applied voltage, V2 be the output voltage and I1 and I2 are the input and output current, let N1 be the number of turns in the primary, let N2 be the number of turns in the secondary. Let V1 be the sinusoidal voltage applied. So when V1 is applied, the flux setup in the core, that is also the sinusoidal, that is given as phi is equal to phi m sin omega t. How we are writing for I is equal to I m sin omega t, V is equal to V m sin omega t, the sinusoidal flux also can be written as phi is equal to phi m sin omega t. But omega is nothing but 2 pi f, when that is substituted here phi m sin omega, omega is 2 pi f, so sin 2 pi f t, where phi m is the peak value of the flux. As per the law of electromagnetic induction, the EMF induced is proportional to the rate of change of flux. For a single turn, it is d phi by dt, for n turns, it is n into d phi by dt. So E can be written as minus n d phi by dt. Where phi is substituted here, phi as phi m sin omega t, when that is differentiated, you will get it as this omega phi m is constant, so take this outside, so n phi m, when sin omega t is differentiated, you will get it as omega cos omega t, so it is minus n omega phi m cos omega t. This cos omega t can be written as sin omega t minus pi by 2. So, you will get it as n omega phi m sin omega t minus pi by 2. This cos omega t is minus sin omega t minus pi by 2. So, that minus, this minus will get cancelled. You will get n omega phi m sin omega t minus pi by 2. The peak value of induced EMF E is equal to n omega phi m. When sin omega t minus pi by 2 is equal to 1, then in induced EMF will be maximum, that is equal to n omega phi m. So that can be given as EM is equal to n omega phi m. The RMS value of induced EMF is E is equal to EM by root 2. But EM is equal to n omega phi m, when that is substituted here, you will get n omega phi m by 2. Omega is 2 pi f. So 2 pi f n phi m by root 2. Here, when you substitute for pi, when you simplify 2 into pi divided by root 2 gives you 4.44. Then f into n into phi m. So this is the expression for the EMF induced in the transformer. If n is equal to n1, for primary the number of turns is equal to n1. So the EMF induced in the primary can be written as E1 is equal to 4.44 into f into n1 into phi m. Similarly for the secondary, the number of turns is equal to n2. So E2 can be written as E2 is 4.44 f into n2 into phi m. Phi m is nothing but peak value of the flux, n is nothing but the number of turns, f is nothing but the frequency applied. Now we'll see what are the different types of the transformer and what is the or construction details that is accounted or you should take care of. These are the types and construction of the transformer. So the primary and the secondary winding insulated from each other and also from the laminated steel core. You have the steel core here. Here the vertical portion called as limbs, horizontal portion called as yoke. In the vertical portion, in the limb, the primary coil is wound here. Similarly here the secondary coil. The primary coil and the secondary coil or secondary winding are insulated from each other. And also from the core it is insulated. The assembled core and the windings are enclosed in a suitable container. You see here, container here, inside the container you have the transformer placed and the bushings to take out the connections here. It is shown here. So the assembled core and the windings are placed in a suitable container. The appropriate bushings, either of the type porcelain or the capacitor type, are used for insulating and also bringing out the terminals of the winding from the enclosure. The entire structure is enclosed in a container. To take out the connection or to connect the load, you need to have the tappings or the port or the openings. So for that, the bushings, it's nothing but a connector. It is bushings are connected here. The core is constructed of transformer sheet laminations fitted together in such a way as to ensure continuous magnetic path with a minimum of air gap. You see here the laminated steel core, the laminations. So it can be in form of E and I or C and I. It is arranged in such a way. It is fitted in such a way to ensure the continuous magnetic path with the minimum of air gap. The steel used for these lamination has high silicon content, which is sometimes heat treated to ensure high permeability and low hysteresis loss as the usual operating flux density. The type of the steel used here, it should have the high silicon content. Sometimes it is heat treated so that the hysteresis losses will be kept minimum. Anyway, we are going to see later what is the hysteresis loss. The types of the transformer. It is the core type and shell type transformer. There are only two types. From the diagram only, you can say in the core type, the windings on the two limbs. Okay, the winding surrounds the core here. But in the shell type, inside the core, the winding is there. So in the middle limb, here in this portion, the winding is, transformer winding is worn. So you can say the core is surrounded, or this winding is surrounded by the core. In core type, core is surrounded, the winding is surrounded here. Here it is, the core is surrounded. Core type transformer, for a single phase transformer, the windings surround a considerable part of the core. The core is rectangular of type. The coils are both circular form or the rectangular form. The windings are located in the opposite limbs of the core. There are two limbs here. In each limb, the windings are there. One for the primary, another one is for the secondary. In most of the large size core, the circular cylindrical coils are used due to its high mechanical strength. Shell type. The core surrounds the considerable portion of the winding. Both the primary and secondary winding on one limb. You see here primary winding and also the secondary winding on a single limb. And the coils are wound in the form of multi-layer disc type. Then on the top another coil, there should be insulation between those two coils, like layer by layer. The different layers of multi-layer disc are insulated from each other by paper. The difference between the core type and shell type transformer. In the core type, winding is placed on two core limbs, but here the winding is placed on the mid limb. Only one magnetic flux path. There is only one path here. There are two paths available here. Here, better cooling, since more surface is exposed to atmosphere. The more winding is exposed to atmosphere, but you can see the winding is inside the core. So cooling is not, by nature, it is not, by construction, it is not effective. It is large size. It is suitable for large size and low voltage. But shell type small size and high voltage, more output for the core type, less output for the shell type. Your winding is surrounded considerable part of the core. Your core is surrounded considerable part of the winding. See here, better mechanical protection coil for the core type, whereas in shell type less mechanical protection. Here easy to repair and maintain. Here it is skilled technician you need to maintain. Maintenance is little difficulty here. Here concentric cylindrical winding are used. Here sandwiched winding are used. So this type of winding one after the other multi-layer kind of arrangement is nothing but the sandwich winding.